This is an antique century repulsion start induction run motor. I don't know where this motor came from. It's something that's been kicking around a long time, and it's seen a hard life. Hole knocked in that, some welding on it right there, but it runs. I've had to disassemble it and replace the short circuiting necklace, which slides up and shorts all the commutator segments when it's running, because that was stuck and full of gum and rust. But the difference in this and a more modern motor, instead of using a capacitor to develop starting torque, this one uses brushes on a commutator. Once it reaches operating speed, or almost operating speed, some flyweights, centrifugal flyweights, pop out and push the brush holders back off of the commutator. It's a brush lifting motor. At the same time, the short circuiter slides back and bridges all the commutator segments together, forming an induction rotor. And it has quite a unique sound. And the lubrication system is interesting too. You fill this cup with oil, and I'm going to turn it by hand, and that ring rides on the shaft through a slot in the bearing, and it picks up the oil and lubricates the bearing. And when it's running, you can see that that turn in there. So when it fires up, you'll hear the brushes ride on the commutator, probably see a spark, and then it'll get quiet. Brushes are picked off the commutator. Oil rings turning. You can see through the damage to the housing, a little bit of oil is coming around the shaft. First, it has some oil in there too. Bearings are made out of solid brass. There's no pores in them for oil to soak through. That's to have liquid oil pouring on it. I don't know how old this motor is. Maybe somebody can tell me. As it stops, you can hear the brushes come back against the commutator. And there you have it.